Hello, good evening. Once again, maayong gabi in our own dialect. Especially to my avid followers in Twitter. And if you are a first timer in my video, let me introduce myself. My name is Ken. Please like my video and subscribe for more future technical updates. And also, please share if you want to. So, first of all, I also want to remind that English is not my native tongue. So, bear with me. All the inconvenience I may cause along the way. So, disclaimer first. I am not a financial advisor. All contents on this blog are solely my own personal views. And for cryptocurrency trading, education, and entertainment purposes only. Crypto, listen very carefully. Cryptocurrency trading is very risky. Losses can exceed deposits. Enter with discretion. You know, everything I gonna discuss going forward is a system based on my own that I created. To make the long story short, I created my own trading system that works for me. Remember, we are dealing with the highest risk class or asset class in the world. Crypto markets are vicious, guys. It's very dangerous to trade, especially when you are trading or dealing with futures or margin trades, where there are risks of being liquidated. So again, nothing beats holding term. It's better to hold, buy and hold, and wait. Time is our friend. There will be days of enormous gains, and the same is true for enormous losses. So learn to take profit. Every day is not Christmas in the crypto space. So I encourage everyone to have at least some basic charts and technical knowledge. So, both I'm a day trader and a long-term holder or investor. If I'm a day trader, I will hold. I will be very cautious, guys, and must do a careful planning of trades. I must analyze the charts very, very carefully, and I won't let my emotions take control. Very disciplined, strict, and if I'm an investor, I will just wait and let the time work for me. So, price are based on experience, 80 to 90% based on the technicals, the price action, especially intraday basis, and 10 to 20% fundamentals, or I call it, like a small boost. So, remember, all cryptocurrencies are subject to the king's price action. So, I am actually very glad that my recent videos, this is the third or fourth, my video somehow is quicker and more straightforward. So, let's begin. So remember, I'm focusing XRP, so others might say I'm biased, but literally I can read any charts, whether it's stocks, forex, anything, because once you got skills in analyzing trends, especially understanding a lot of technicals, guys, you can analyze any other trading instruments. But in my case, I'm focusing the cryptocurrencies and my favorite crypto of all time, which is XRP, which is the fastest cryptocurrency in the world. So, you know, I lay out already in my Twitter profile, I already pinned it, and over time this creates an impression that I'm an XRP believer. So this is where I started, so I will continue. This is where I I've been known. So, where are we now? We are in the future, guys. Soon, this fourth year bear market, bear means since the previous all-time high was not yet reclaimed, so we are literally in more on selling market. A very, you know, more on downside. But soon it will be over. This year is XRP's year. I have the feeling, and I've been following XRP for second year now. You know, especially after the pandemic hit the world. So let's continue. So my video today is entitled My XRP Bitcoin Plus Full Bitcoin Full Technical Report for April 20, that's Tuesday, Intraday Hidden Inverted Bullish Flag. I will explain this in the later part. So where do I begin? So first, basic, we start with the Bitcoin. Okay, today again, it's still in the descending or the inverted bearish flag trading region, but it tried to move up, but it found resistance in this area around here. So today's trading or intraday, its low is 52 percent or index, and the high is 54. But like I said many times since I started doing this video for consecutive number of days, even though how tired I am, I do my best to deliver every day. So the more Bitcoin or the lower it's the dominance rate, the better for an explosive alt season. I'm not going to explain that any further. Actually, I want a Bitcoin dominance index to hit below 50% or better the 40%. So we'll continue tracking that. So let's move to the total crypto market cap. So again, today is not that actually a good day, since in the last 4 days alone, since Bitcoin achieved, remember when Bitcoin creates a new all-time high, the crypto total market cap, remember its index rate, its dominance rate is very big, guys, 50% above. So it is the leader or the king of the cryptocurrencies. So when it moves up, the price will move up as well. So today it found a very crucial support after the market did a sell off earlier to as low as 1.84. but good thing those people who have waited for so long that they finally made their entries. I can see it. A lot of people bought today just by looking at this candle. So, but we still have time. Tomorrow's close will be around 10 hours from now, with some 10 hours approximation. So still plenty left of time. So we might see a higher or lower. We will not know, but tomorrow we will find out. So the crypto total market cap actually in correcting process, but soon it will go back here above this yellow line. And once this price correction is done, led by the crypto leader Bitcoin, then we will move again. Remember this 2 trillion I keep saying in my in my early videos, if you keep if you have followed me closely, guys, I keep saying 2 trillion cap is a psychological level and it is no more. It's now a reality. That is what I keep on saying, and we will continue move upward and upward, because there was never a time, guys, that the total crypto market cap after reaching high went to the previous levels, especially after the whole world hit COVID hit by COVID-19 pandemic. So crypto boom and bloom, not doom and it was not another term I say, sorry for the confusion. What I'm trying to say is the pandemic became a catalyst for the cryptocurrency to emerge as new emerging market. Remember, the traditional trading system is Forex, boring stocks, shares, ETFs, precious metals, but crypto, even though it's still in its to be exact 11th year or 12th year, because Bitcoin is the foundation of crypto, it's still very young. But remember, if you notice, we are the crypto market cap is now in the true 2 trillion mark in just short of time, in just a decade. So the price, the total crypto market cap will continue to move upward. So let's proceed now to the Bitcoin department. So we are now in the sixth day of consolidation, or the price went sideways after achieving a new all-time high last April 14. So far so good. It tried to let me hide the drawing, guys, so that my chart is very messy. Only me can understand it. But you know, if you want to learn, guys, I can teach you. Just PM me, just send me a message. So let me hide this. Sorry. You know, I'm doing impromptu videos. Just strike one, no more. Take two, take three, take four. So let me hide the drawings first. Okay. So today, it tried to touch the cloud again. Remember, I said the last touch on the cloud was way back in this in the September. I explained that in the last 2 days. So today, the daily cloud, or the Ichimoku cloud, Japanese word, I don't have to tell you the details, but the cloud, this cloud here, represents a warning. Once the candles, the price are above, when it touch, it will try to move down, but it will be a battle between buyers and sellers. But today, the sellers were rejected. They were rejected. So buyers are in control. So let me turn on the drawings again. So today, what was that? Right here. So the Ichimoku cloud again was touched today. So that is 229 days. But the good thing, it didn't give the buyers, or the supports didn't give the sellers a chance to touch here. So that would be catastrophic. You know what mean what means if catastrophic means more price going down, or the price will go down even more. So what will happen? Remember, when Bitcoin dumps hard, every crypto market currencies like XRP, Ethereum, whatever favorite you got there, all will go down. When the king go down, all of its dominions will go down as well. others will even suffer twice damage. Even just a few drops, dips from Bitcoin, everything will down. So this is how risky trading in crypto markets are, but very rewarding if done right. High risk but high reward, but just do it right. I've been doing that many times, so I'm in a profitable business. So far so good, thank you Lord. So let me continue. So other charts for Bitcoin, you know, I open a lot of windows in my let's say when I do a lot of work in trading, I open as many as 12 max windows. So under normal time like this, I just open around 5 to 6 or maybe 8. So but at times that I really need to do a very careful trading plan, I will open a lot because I need to see a lot of indicators in order for me to make money. So today this chart also, this is a good look, better than previously, but you know, I set this up already. Nothing to worry about, we are near in the bottom. Let me count around 2 to 3 days left. Once the we want an RSI, stochastic RSI looks like this. So many will sell, not yet. Many people and large hedge funds, large companies, any people or big institutions will sell. Will still sell because I'm not yet convinced. This is not yet the finish. More will sell later, but the buy volumes are coming, slowly coming. We want volumes like this, guys. This and especially this. So once the red line go down here, we wait. Remember, trading is not rushing, because if you rush, then go to the casino, cash in there and you lose. Trust me, crypto markets are highly volatile. If you don't know how to trade here, you lose. Especially if you are trading in futures, your money will be lost in just few snap of fingers. So I'm not trying to urge anyone to do trading. Remember my disclaimer. So the buy volumes will try to keep up and form a buy signal. Buy signal means it cross the red line and price will go back up. Again, back in business, creating new higher lows and higher highs like that. So I don't need to explain much further. Let me proceed here. So here, this is another chart for Bitcoin. This is called moving averages. Moving averages, based on my study, I use this a lot. This is very, very important because the green line is the 50-day moving average as short term. This is the 100-day moving average midterm, and the 200 moving average. This is under extreme market volatile condition, like people all over the world in panic, another war, breakout, anything, price will go fast, very, very fast. And these areas here will try, in time, will act as resistance or supports. So far today, if you see, guys, in the previous days, look at these candles here. These 50-day lines, the green line, acted as support. But today, the price or the candles went below it. So they became, the 50 green line became a resistance. So when was the last time the green line was touched? Let us simplify things. No need to complicate anything. So the last stat was in reference today was 83 days. Next, touch here, multiple touches on March 25 and 26. Just few days after my birthday. So let me close, let me proceed this also, 25 days. So today, the green line was touched, but last 3 days ago, and yesterday, 1 day, so here we are. So it clearly shows here that the 50 green day SMA or green line is now the resistance. So buyers or the bulls, bisons, I love to use that terms, because in trading, investments, there are a lot of terms or lingos. So buyers will try to push the price up again, and soon this will become a support once more. So let's proceed. You know guys, today I'm very grateful because a friend of mine, also a good trader, I don't need to mention his name. Taught me about something. So he taught me about weighted moving average, especially in the weekly. So he said to me that it's very important to learn WMA or weighted moving average, especially in the weekly side, because the 21 to be exact, because this indicator acts as a warning for in case of a selling market like happening today. For 2 weeks now, the Bitcoin last week very volatile, hit a high of 64 just 1 week ago and moved down as fast as it went high, the same as the faster it went below. So today, at least the Bitcoin in the weekly chart created a higher high. So I'm very worried if the price touches here. So from now on, I will use the WMA21 as another helpful indicator. So let's proceed now to the XRP, my main event of the show. You know, I've been working hard a lot, so today is XRP, another XRP technical. So today, let me go to my trading view. This is a premium account. I paid 2,000 plus here, or almost 3,000. Thank you so much for you, boss. You know who you are. If you are watching my video, if you are listening, thank you so much. God bless you more, sir. Thank you for believing in my talents. I will continue to work harder and harder each day. Thanks a lot once again. So right now, XRP entered 6th day of consolidation after attaining a new multi-year high. Not all-time high, not yet. But like I said, we still have around 3 to 4 days of correction. Once this is true, all the bids are cleared, all the wary investors, those people that are new, especially the newbies, I do not like to use the term noobs, because if I use that, I will be rude. No, everybody has to start somewhere. Everyone has beginning. I was there, I was new before. So you know, markets are just like an open field. Lots of professional traders, lots of veterans. So a mix in and out. So a lot of people will still sell. I'm not yet convinced. Once a full correction is done within 3 to 4 days, then XRP is back in the business of destroying these two resistance. I call this the psychological level. I will put a line here. So not yet, we're not yet done. So let's proceed now to the other chart. So XRP, guys, look at, guys, the cloud, very very far. Look at Bitcoin, very very near. You know what that means? I'm very bullish, guys. I'm very very bullish for XRP. Soon, $2 plus. I'm very very excited. Once price correction is done, we will RSI, the daily RSI is very good, creating a perfect bounce from the downside, the support and the resistance also. Soon we will retest a lot of loss. Look at, guys, a perfect bottoming in the bottom, here, rounding bottom. It create a rounding bottom pattern. And look at perfect clearing of people. A lot of triggered stop loss. Look at the volumes in the 5 days. Look at and the candle for today, very very sexy. It formed a hammer, a very bullish hammer. And when a hammer, listen very carefully, when you see a candle like this after a downtrend, we are in a 5-day downtrend, guys. Look at that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is the top found near the $2. So when we found a candle like this, expect a bounce back up, please. And every prices that are lost here, the 1.50, the 1.71, the retracement numbers, I don't have to explain about retracement, because if I do that, we will acquire a lot of time. So just to make things easier, XRP will retest the missing the loss. This is a key support levels. They became resistance now, but in time, just like what I explained a few minutes ago, once XRP finishing the correction in 3 to 4 days, I hope and I pray that it will be lessened, or just like at least 2 to 3 days, then XRP is back in the business, guys. And let's also check the moving averages. This is my title, the meaning. I will explain now. So in the daily, good the XRP is very above in the moving averages compared here in the Bitcoin. Bitcoin's 50 became a resistance, but in the XRP, it is so above, guys. Look, very bullish. So, and we go to the 1 hour time frame. This is it. I already created this. Look, a perfect reconquered or conquering on the 50-day, the hourly SMA. This became now a support. So soon, XRP will target here, this line here, and here. Once this happened, guys, let me screenshot this. Okay, and we put this in paint. Okay, guys, this is what I'm seeing. I am seeing, based on the drawing, my title, remember, my title is Intraday Hidden Inverted Bullish Flag. Where is the flag? Why I said hidden? It is hidden to those people that do not understand charts, but I know how to read charts and understand the patterns. So this is, guys, this is the inverted. Inverted means reverse. This is the flag pull, and the flag itself, the flag pull is there, and the flag is the red line here is the resistance. It was the a breakout occurred, and after creating lower highs and higher lows, the support is here, and this level here is broken. It was tested, though some few drawbacks. We might see a touch here, but price will still go up. And why I'm so bullish? Remember this is the 50 green line. I am so bullish, guys. Green will go here. The blue, while the blue, this the blue, the 100 hourly SMA will go here. 50 is the fastest moving average, guys. It's very important to see the moving averages. As you know, I've been using this a lot in my trading strategies. So the red is here. So what will happen is this. Let me draw it once again. Okay. What will happen is the green will move fast, conquering the here and here, multiple crosses, and price will back to business or normal. So that answered my title. Why I said intraday hidden inverted bullish plug. Intraday means today. So today we use only today. We start the opening, the April 20 opening, Tuesday trading here, and we are still not yet done. But this is a live video, so I need to see you. I need to show this to you so that you understand. So I am bullish. I am seeing. This is very hidden, but I saw it with my. Thank God I saw this. So I'm still bullish. So meanwhile, let's go to the weekly chart. I use Bitstamp because in this video I use Binance. So here, look at, guys, still a lot of work to do, a lot of supply here. I don't have much time left, as much as I want to do to quicken this video, but there are some things that I don't have time to explain. But just for the sake of doing this video for today, let me just say the important highlights. So 1.33 is a retracement number, of important Fibonacci retracement. 1.33 is reconquered in the weekly, and the number the WMA21 is here sitting pretty away, and the golden weekly cross is still valid. Very bullish, guys. So I will put here weekly golden cross still valid, fast approaching. The retracement here, the Fibonacci retracement number in reference to the previous all-time high here is 0.382, which sits the 1.33 to 1.3. This is a very important support now. The price is good job. The price is stayed in the 1.34. The sellers try to sell, but buyers are rushing to defend. So that's a good. So next stop is here. Before we go back to the 1.71, the next stop is the 1.56, 1.57, then 1.71. So let me put reclaim as support. Next stops 1.56, then 1.56. That this is the exact way of trading, guys. Patience will pay off. And finally, 1.71. I will not discuss the upper prices. We focus first on the next target. So that's it for now. I'm bullish. I already explained myself. So once again, thank you so much for staying. I forgot. Sorry, Boss Jed Makalib, the creator of XLM, it's like a younger brother XRP. He sold again today, Tuesday, and to close my report, he has 86 days left, and the nightmare of XRP will soon be finished. So that's it, guys. Thank you for listening and staying with me until the end of my video for tonight or today. or afternoon, wherever you are right now, if you are listening, God bless you. Thank you so much for supporting me. And let's meet again tomorrow. So, thanks a lot and bye-bye.